Bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhasse namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhasse namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhasse Hansa dicca pati ante akase ante ittiya nibbanti dhira lokamha jetva maram savasanante. Dear venerables, dear devotees, today is our fourth day of this intensive meditation retreat. We saw all the venerables, they are effortful. They are maintaining their practice continuously. It is very good sign. We have to maintain next 3 days also same effort. We all can experience for the wholesome happiness, meditation happiness. We can experience calmness, comfortableness, brightness, concentration. We can experience later strong mindfulness and wisdom also experience. So we determine to maintain our practice continuously for next few days. Then we recite Dhammapada verse, it comes from Lokavagga. The Buddha preached while residing at Jetavana Monastery. In the verse Buddha explaining, the swans, they are flying on the sky. The person who have the psychic power also flying in the sky. Wiseful one, they overcome all the maras and defilements and attain arahant. So these three things Buddha had been explaining. Reason is the 30 venerables, those venerables called Baddhavaggyas, or another name is called Pavayakas. Those venerables, they ordained 20 years before the Buddha preaching this Dhamma, beginning period of the Buddha's Sasana. All were prince. All they listen Buddha's Dhamma, all they ordain, all of them attain. Youngest one, Sotapanna, eldest one, Anagami. Others, middle of the attainment. All not attain Arahant, but all attain some path portions. All the 30 venerables, after ordinations, go to the far away and had been practicing for 20 years. After 20 years, they thought of go to the Lord Buddha and pay respect. They are coming on the way, heavy rain. So cannot go to the Jetavana Monastery. Halfway they stop for the Vassana. Then after immediately Vassana period, going to the Jetavana Monastery, heavy rain, roads muddy, many plants, very difficult. All the ropes that are muddy and wet. When they enter the Jetavana Monastery, so Venerable Ananda saw and go to prepare the venerables, the staying and also drinks, these things we call a duty, that guest duties Venerable Ananda had been preparing. All the venerables go to the Lord Buddha, pay respect. Buddha asked Venerable how he had been living. The venerables answered, Vante, living is not difficult thing for us. But the journey from there to here, very difficult journey. Road many muddy and also many difficulties we had to pass. All wet ropes, with wet ropes, muddy, raining, together we had to come. Many difficulties. So the Buddha says, Venerable, that through your difficulties. But when you are seeing your past lives, you had been having hell for many longer period. So sometimes cannot come up from hells and suffering. The samsara is the most difficult journey. This journey is not the difficult one. The samsara, rebirth cycle, is the difficult journey. So Buddha had been explaining detailly about the samsara. So that one of the sutta called Anamatagga, Buddha had been explaining. All those 30 venerables, all of them, they all attain arahant while listening to this dhamma. So then pay respect Lord Buddha, go back by sky. Venerable Ananda prepare all the staying, drinks everything and come and cannot see the venerable. Ask Bhante, where the venerable gone? Oh, Buddha says, Venerable, go back. How go back? By sky. How it happened? They come by walking, very difficulty, many muddy. Immediately, how they go? Venerable Ananda, they listen Dhamma, they attain Arahant, then they go back. So then Buddha asked Venerable Ananda to accumulate, gather all the venerables. And Buddha put up some rules also, veneer rules for the vasa entry and also cuttiness. Those things, and Buddha preached this Dhamma to the Venerable Sangha. Many of the venerables, they could attain some path and process. In there, Buddha explaining, swan, they are flying in the sky. The psychic power ones also flying on the sky. The wiseful one, they overcome all the defilements together with all the maras. The Buddha had been explaining, many they could attain path process. So in the Dhamma, the Buddha explained, swan, they are flying because they're born with this ability. Birds and other flying abilities, they're born. It's called, they are born karma. They have these feathers and they can fly. But the human beings, they cannot fly. Human beings, they're born, they can walk on earth. But if any human being, they develop their mentalities, mind become more and more subtle, more and more lighter, they can make body also lighter, they can fly over the sky. Because this flying depends on your concentration. If the concentration better and better, body get lighter and lighter, can fly. So this is big procedure, but can do. In the Buddha time, many they could do, this 30 venerable also could do, many could do. Nowadays also, we cannot say it is not available, should have in the world, because many they are practicing in the world. One of the story we heard in Myanmar, so one venerable come to the village Pindapath. Villagers never see this venerable. They offer food. After offered, one or two devotees, they little bit distance together, they follow venerable to see where the venerable had been stayed. They go up to the end of the village, somewhere there near the forest somewhere. Venerable go to the sky and go back. So the where devotee understood, oh, venerable, stay far away, come here by the psychic powers. So such a things, we cannot, maybe we don't have enough ability, enough merit to see it. But this, such a things had been happening in the world together with the deeper meditations. So we also can have some of the experiences, maybe not flying, at least some of the experiences. So that our venerables, we know, working very hard, we have to train this meditation continuously. Later you can experience this kind of thing. But to get this kind of experience, we need lot of effort, lot of practice. Beginning period of the ordination or practice, we have to use the energies in double level, because one thing is our concentration factors, that means concentration factors or faculties, very weakened. We have to bring up these faculties. We need a lot of energy to bring it up. Another one is our defilements very stronger beginning. We need lot of energy to subside the defilements. Because of these two reasons, beginning period, we have to work very hard for meditation developments. We know it is difficult, sometimes leg pain, back pain, even though we are effortful, it is very important. We know that you are painful, but like the Buddha teach to the Venerable, 30 Venerable, you can compare in the samsara. Samsara, you had been in a hell and suffering many places, many times had been suffering, and today you are suffering a little bit for meditation. You can compare which one is more. This 1-2 hour suffering is very little. Samsara, we had been in hell and suffering a lot. So with comparing, it is that earlier suffering, this suffering is very little. But we have to ignore this suffering for future happiness. You ignore this suffering and practice, later you get future happiness, later you are very comfortable. So therefore, that determine to train the mind continuously until you reach your happiness. So according to the Buddha's teaching, concentration is very important. If anyone have the concentration, the ordination life, practicing path, very comfortable. Because hindrances is very weakened. If not, ordination life very difficult because of the many hindrances, that lustful thoughts, hatred thoughts, and also sloth and torpor and distractions, doubtfulness, remorse, all the thoughts are very strong. Life is very uncomfortable. But after having the concentration, life is very comfortable, peaceful, because all the hindrances are not active. Mind very peaceful, so therefore that we have to put up a lot of effort to bring up the concentration. In the ordination life, it is very useful. You can see, when you are reading a book, if you are not concentrating, not easily keep away something, some dhamma there inside the mind because of the distractions. But after having the concentration, you just focus very easily dhamma absorption. Contents absorption very easy because of the concentration. Same thing, that without concentration, dhamma absorption not easy. With the concentration, dhamma absorption, dhamma understanding very easier. So therefore, you have to spend some time for the concentration and have to build up. So that you are walking time, eating time, sleeping time, all the time, concentration there, life is comfortable. Such a life, we have to train more and more. Then later you can have the psychic powers and other deeper knowledges. So those knowledges based on your practice, so effortful practice, energetic practice, it is very important to experience your happiness, your future deep developments. So the Buddha's teaching always encourage for the concentration and also wisdom. So we all come here for meditation development. So we had to put up a lot of effort for it. Beginning, it is not easy. Sometimes this whole retreat don't have very good results, little bit only. But second retreat also we do, little bit results come. Third, fourth, fifth, definitely good results come. If your first retreat maybe not much effective, second one also little bit, third one more effective, fourth, fifth, sixth retreats, you get more deeper concentration. So until concentration and until deeper development appearing, we have to maintain same effort. But some are lazy for this retreat, second one also lazy, so they never experience deeper calmness, concentration and brightness. It is very important to maintain continuous effort. So we know our Venerables, we all put up a lot of effort for meditation developments. This effort further we have to maintain. So definitely we can experience deeper concentration. If the concentration, the ordination life is more valuable. If no concentration, ordination life no less value. You know, sometimes we have concept, if we have dhamma knowledge, ordination life very easy, very comfortable. No. Knowledge actually cannot remove the defilements. Knowledge is just knowledge only, still your defilements remain. But if the concentration have, your defilements temporarily subside. Later vipassana knowledge come, defilements gone away from your mind, Your life is very calm and comfortable. Ordination life is very easily maintained. If not, ordination life is suffering. So therefore that we determine to maintain our continuous practice and experience deeper concentration and later experience deeper meditation developments. So the meditation that we need lot of effort to bring up our meditation mind. It is not easy work. Sometimes we are working very hard even though no proper results. In an earlier, one of the teacher explained, in the meditation background, no one there who not cry because they are working very hard, but no proper results, sometimes feel of crying. This common thing, even cry also doesn't matter. We maintain our practice, later you can stop your crying. This common thing, because you are sometimes working very hard, painfulness, body, mind, not easy control mind, many defilements, we know it. But to overcome these difficulties, the only way is the meditation. No other way, no other choices. So therefore that we have to train our meditation mind continuously. One example we explained, for us also, same thing happened beginning period of ordination. Sometimes we work very hard for meditation practice, but not easy meditation development. So sometimes that cannot do any of the meditation, tension, head, back, whole body tension. So it cannot do anything. So go to the empty place. Only thing is we can talk to the Buddha and recite Buddha quality in our own language and Pali. When you are talking, again, tearing comes because of faith. Buddha's work, Buddha's enlightenment, Buddha's duties. When you are focusing it, again tearing. But because of the faith, then we go for meditation and sit very comfortable. That time we don't know the reason. Later we undertook, not done by the devas, it is by our own mentalities, mental factor. Faith mental factor grow up, all the tension disappear. So earlier our Dhamma talk also we explained, if you have tension, some difficulties, please bring up your faith mental factors together with the reflection of Buddha qualities. So meditation become comfortable, definitely comfortable. So this kind of experience we need in this meditation background. Later, easy maintain concentration, easy maintain mindfulness, easy maintain wisdom. Even while walking, while traveling, also you can maintain your meditation. Later, very easy maintain your meditation. So therefore, we have to determine continuous practice. You can have many of the experiences. All these experiences, future will become very good, very big support for your meditation developments. So the meditation experience, very important. All the experience come with our effort and our experiments. All we need, different type experiment, how to overcome my defilements, lustful thoughts, hatred thoughts, delusion. How to overcome? All of us, we have many. We know it is. We also come from that background. We all know. We remind one of the experience, maybe useful for you, but not, we are explaining not for the conceit, but for the Dhamma, for you to encourage. We had the meditation program in earlier Galdhuva, we ordained 1992, 1994. Two of the Mahasi teachers come to the Galdhuva. Before also we had been practicing Mahasi meditation, basically, some other practice also. In 1994, these two teachers, O Venerable Sangvara, Venerable Jatila, those two Venerable, is conducting meditation retreats. Many of the Venerable participated. We also participated. One occasion, we got very big, very strongest lustful thoughts. Go to the teacher and inform. Teacher says, oh, let's label it. Notice it. We try, not works. It is the defilements is strongest. We try labeling, not work. But later, because earlier we had experience with the four element practice. But because of this Mahasi label system, we already stopped it, because now always we try to focus labeling. It not work. Later, I thought, no, I have to use own experience one. We bring this four element experience to these lustful thoughts, immediately disappear, completely disappear and vanish. That very comfortable feeling, because earlier very suffering feeling, try to meditate, cannot meditate, the lustful thoughts. But this apply these four elements, immediately disappear, very comfortable. So this kind of experience you all need, how to dissolve your lustful thoughts, how to dissolve your hatred thoughts, how to dissolve your conceit thoughts. You need some of the experience. This experience you can apply, you can dissolve your defilements. So that this experience come if you are involved your meditation. Always involved. That in earlier we remember, we are studying also, but immediately after studying, we again come back to the meditation background. The same way you also have to maintain whatever you are, duty or anything, immediately you have to come to the meditation background so you can have various of the meditation experiences. So those experiences, very important for you to dissolve your difficulties, dissolve your defilements, maintain calmness, concentration. So always determined to maintain more and more practice so that during this retreat, after retreat also every day, few hours, we determined to maintain our meditation practice. So few of the questions come. So that one question is asking, Venerable Sir, please explain 10 type of the asubhas and also 9 type of the sivatikas, dead bodies. So in the Satipatthana Suttas, the Lord Buddha explaining, please explain. Actually, this is not the time for explaining detailly. You can see the Satipatthana books, you can get some of the ideas of how to practice. Generally, we are explaining the asubha is 10 types. We know the first one is that swollen body. Body is swollen. After death, body is swollen. Second one is blue color body. Body become blue color. Third one is that liquid come out. Mouth, nose, and some places liquid coming out body. Fourth one is that some of the big cut, big injuries place, big split body. Some your stomach open up, legs open, some of the open places, there are many. That this fifth one is animal eating body. That sixth one is the body that already flesh disappear and also blood, the sinews, bone only remain. Seventh one is the body, some part separated, leg, hand, but all the flesh disappear. The other things, they are little bit blood. And also sinews and these things, they are available. Next one is warm body, many warm, full of warm. And also the next one is skeleton body. So this kind of 10 the asubhas there. And also now Sivatika also 9 time of also bit closer, but not exactly similar. We had to contemplate until the bone also disappeared, the bone also become powder. So various way we contemplate, we call asubha. The asubha is one of the very important meditation, very useful meditation. Our teachers, Aridham Mahatheras, always encourage for asubha. If anyone train asubha Mahatheras, saying that you can live without attaining arahant is equal to the arahant, because means you know, don't have the defilements. If your asubha is stronger, your defilements vanish, all the lustful, these defilements vanish, you can live like the arahant. So valuable one. So we explain asubha steps bit, you know, the repulsiveness steps, few steps. The first step is when you are contemplating repulsiveness or bodily parts, not easy see. First step, cannot see the body or bodily parts or dead body or warm body, you cannot see. But you are again repeating and contemplating, you are focusing, wording only, labeling only. When you are labeling, focusing it again, the second stage is, it becomes clearer and clearer. Warm body become clear and clear. Bodily parts become clear and clear. Very comfortable. Then next step is you get a little bit brightness, all the parts disappear, all the body disappear, warm body disappear. Earlier you had been contemplate warm body disappear. Now, but comfortable for you, sitting comfortable, sometimes worry, oh, what happened to my focusing, what happened to my object disappear, worrying come. But had to understand, further had to focus your object inside the brightness. Next stage, you keep your focus inside the brightness, your object keep inside the brightness, warm body you keep inside the brightness, or body parts you keep inside the brightness, then become very clear inside the brightness, very comfortable, you can maintain fourth stage. If this stage also very clear, then you can enter the absorption, dhyana concentration. Dhyana only push dhyana, you have to maintain apply mind, we call vitakka, together you can maintain. You have to repeat again, warm body, full of the warm body, repulsive body, you have to repeat, then you can maintain the paschjhana concentration. So asubha is one of the very important, very useful meditation practice. We determine, we every day repeat train, asubha also more useful. So next question is Venerable asking that when we have the jhana concentration, can we hear the external sound? Venerable is asking, the excess concentration we can hear, we can do other works also, but jhana concentration is different. Jhana means absorption. In the jhana period we cannot have any of the sound, but deepest jhana concentration very less people in the world. In the Buddha, some occasion happened, Buddha had made happen, and some of the deepest one available. But those venerable or those deepest one, they don't hear any of the sound during this concentration period, in deepest level. But most of others, their concentration not so deep, they are sitting for 1 hour or 2 hour concentration. But maybe after few minutes it little bit break it. Maybe 1-2 minutes later you little bit break. During this period you can hear sound. Again you concentrate 1-2 minutes, again little bit can break. During this period can hear any noise, sound, outside sound. This way, outside sound depend on the your breaking of the your concentration. If not, no any sound for the jhana concentration. So we had been explaining that excess concentration can have. In our Sri Lanka, one of the story in the commentaries, one of the venerable, he got psychic power. The psychic power going flying in sky, this thing can do, but flying time, not the jhana, flying time only access concentration. Before that we need jhana concentration, jhana power, then after jhana power we have to determine for flying. In flying time you come to the access concentration. The venerable now flying on the sky. Venerable here, one young girl is plugging the flowers. There, so she was singing. Venerable hear this singing voice and also got attractive to the girl. Slowly Venerable come down to the girl place, later disrobe also. So this kind of thing is in Dhamma Daya. Means even flying time also can hear this kind of thing. But it is not the jhana level. Jhana time is different. So we understand the jhana concentration is very deeper level. Jhana javanas continuously happening for a few minutes, so 1 hour or 2 hours, depend on our mastery, depend on our concentration, deeper levels. Second part of the question is asking how to reflect the jhana factors, focusing your bhavanga mind, focusing your heart base. That part we had been explaining in an earlier Dhamma talk, last one. We had did 2 days before, how to focus the concentration. When you just after concentration, focus your heart base, reflect jhana factors one by one, later hold together within 1 or 2 minutes. Those things we had been explaining, that if you have this condition, you can ask teacher, teacher can explain it. Next part of the question is, the without determination, can we enter the jhana concentration? Yes, can. If you have the concentration very well developed, very well mastered concentration, where naturally your concentration come, but you're not well master one, you need more and more training, more and more determination, together only your concentration comes. So that the well master one, they can enter the concentration very easier. So that one occasion our Mahathir had explained, Haridam Mahathir, when he go to the teacher's place, so that some outsiders come to the teacher for some dhamma, Venerable have some time to had to stay outside. When he Venerable is staying outside, standing, posture very comfortable, feel like floating, you know, on the sky, concentrated, natural. Because of the concentration, deeper concentration, naturally it comes, your concentration, you not drop down. So such a concentration very easily, naturally come. So the questions is talking about the jhana concentrations. So we know our Venerables, all meditators, they are working very hard. So we again encourage for Venerable to continue practice during this retreat, and later on so we determine to maintain our practice and experience deeper concentration, experience mindfulness and wisdoms. Later you will be shining with the Dhamma, your light become more Dhamma power, because of the concentration, because of the wisdom, because of the mindfulness, Dhamma become better and better for your life. Your life become shining for yourself. When you are shining Dhamma in your life, it is the shining for the Buddha Sasana. So we wish all of you to fulfill your practice, and wish all of you to attain all the concentrations, all the attainment, path, portions and nibbana. Theruvan Saranai.